Jeanette and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this solved official exercise, we are going to determine the differential equation that governs the variation of the voltage across a capacitor fed by a constant voltage. Determine the constants A, B, and tau in the solution of the differential equation. Determine the expression of the charge current. Calculate the value of the resistance R of the rheostat. Determine the expression of the voltage UR across the rheostat. Calculate the value of the capacitance C. Verify graphically the value of the capacitance C.
The aim of this exercise is to determine the capacitance of a capacitor. We set up the shown series circuit. This circuit includes an ideal battery E of 10 volts, a rheostat of resistance R, a capacitor of capacitance C, an ammeter of negligible resistance, and a switch K. The capacitor is initially uncharged, and we close the switch at time zero. Number one, write the expression of the current in terms of C and UC, where UC equal UBD is the voltage across the capacitor. Since the positive sense enters the capacitor through the plate of charge Q, then I is equal to plus dQ by dt, but Q is equal to C times UBD, or is equal to C times UC. Then dQ by dt is equal to C times dUC by dt. Number two, determine the differential equation that shows the variation of UC. Applying Kirchhoff's voltage law, UPN is equal to UPB plus UBD plus UDN. Since UPB is the voltage across a closed switch plus the voltage across an ammeter of negligible resistance, then UPB is equal to zero. UPD is equal or is taken as UC, and UDN is equal to RI since the positive sense is oriented from D to N through the resistor. Now replace I by C DUC by DT. So E is equal to UC plus RC DUC by DT. Divide both sides by RC, we get the first order differential equation that governs the variation of UC during charging.
Let's move to part 3. The solution of this equation is of the form UC is equal to A plus B e to the power minus T over tau. Determine the expressions of the constants A, B, and tau in terms of E, R, and C. To determine the expressions of the constants, first we must differentiate UC with respect to time, and then we will substitute its derivative into the differential equation. So this is UC, and we need to differentiate it with respect to time. The derivative of A is equal to zero because A is constant. To differentiate this expression with respect to time, let me remind you with this remark. If you have a function A times e to the power bt, where A and B are constants, then its derivative with respect to time is AB times e to the power bt. So this is going to be duc by dt is equal to zero, which is the derivative of A, plus b into minus 1 over tau times e to the power minus t over tau. This is going to be minus b over tau times e to the power minus t over tau. Now, this is our differential equation. We will replace duc by dt and uc by their expressions. So we will get this equation. This term is duc by dt, and this term is uc. Rearrange. This is going to be minus b over tau e to the power minus t over tau plus a over rc plus b over rc e to the power minus t over tau is equal to e over rc. Let's take b e to the power minus t over tau as a common factor. We will get this equation. Now, the right side of this equation is constant, then the left side must be constant. This term is constant. Now, this term must be constant, but the exponential function is a variable. So, this term is constant only if minus b over tau plus b over rc is zero. Then this is going to be A over RC is equal to E over RC, which means that small a is equal to E, and minus B over tau plus B over RC is equal to zero, which means that tau is equal to RC. Now we determined the expressions of A and tau. We still have B. How can we determine the expression of B? At time zero, UC is equal to zero. So let's replace UC by zero and T by zero in the expression of UC. This is going to be zero is equal to A plus B times E to the power zero, which means that B is equal to minus A, but A is equal to capital A, then B is equal to minus capital A.
Part 4. Deduce that the expression of the current is I equal E over R exponential minus T over RC. We know that I equal C DUC by DT, and UC, which is equal to A plus B exponential minus T over tau. In the previous slide, we proved that A is equal to E, B is equal to minus E, and tau is equal to RC. Then UC becomes E minus E exponential minus T over RC. Now, let's differentiate UC with respect to time. E is constant, then the derivative of E with respect to time is zero. And the derivative of minus E exponential minus T over RC is equal to minus E times minus 1 over RC exponential minus T over RC. This is going to be E over RC exponential minus T over RC. Now, replace DUC by DT by E over RC exponential minus T over RC. So I becomes CE over RC exponential minus T over RC. C cancels C, then I becomes E over R exponential minus T over RC. Part 5. The ammeter indicates a value I of 0 equal 5 milliamperes at time 0. Deduce the value of R. Using the expression of the current, now substitute I equal 5 times 10 to the power minus 3 amperes. E is equal to 10 volts and T is equal to 0. So R is equal to 2,000 ohms. Part 6. Write the expression of the voltage across the resistor UR, which is equal to UDN, in terms of ERC and T. We know that UR, which is equal to UDN, is equal to R times I. Replace I by E over R exponential minus T over RC, then R becomes, or UR is equal to R E over R exponential minus T over RC. R cancels R, then UR becomes E exponential minus T over RC.
Focus, please. This is important.
Let's move to part 7. At an instant T1, the voltage across the capacitor is equal to UR. 7.1. Show that T1 is equal to RC ln 2. In a previous slide, we have capital E is equal to UC plus UR, but UC is equal to UR. Then replace UC by UR. This is going to be 2UR. In the previous slide, we obtained the expression of UR, then replace UR by its expression. This is going to be capital E is equal to 2E times E to the power minus T1 over RC. This is going to be 0.5 is equal to e to the power minus T1 over RC. Take the reciprocal of both sides of this equation. This is going to be 2 is equal to e to the power T1 over RC. Now take the natural logarithm of both sides of this equation. So ln 2 is equal to ln e to the power T1 over RC. But ln e to the power T1 over RC is equal to T1 over RC. This is going to be T1 is equal to RC ln 2. Part 7.2. Calculate the value of C knowing that T1 is equal to 1.4 milliseconds. So we will use this equation. We will replace each physical quantity by its value. T1 is equal to 1.4 milliseconds, which is equal to 1.4 times 10 to the power minus 3 seconds. Capital R is equal to 2,000 ohms, and then C is equal to 1 times 10 to the power minus 6 farads.
Part 8. In order to verify the value of C, we vary the value of R. This document represents tau as a function of R. 8.1. Show that the shape of this curve is in agreement with the expression of tau obtained in part 3. Look at the curve. It is a straight line passing through the origin and having a positive slope. So we have to prove that tau versus R is a straight line and having a positive slope and passing through the origin. In part 3, we proved that tau is equal to R times C, but C is constant, so tau and R are directly proportional. Therefore, the curve of tau versus R must be a straight line passing through the origin with a positive slope, so tau versus R is in agreement with the shape of this curve. 8.2. Using this curve, determine again the value of C. Since tau equals R times C, and C is constant, so C is the slope of this curve, and C can be given as delta tau over delta R. Now we take two points from the curve. The first point having an abscissa 3 times 10 to the power 3 ohms and an ordinate 3 times 10 to the power minus 3 seconds. And the second point having an abscissa 0 and an ordinate 0. So delta tau is equal to 3 times 10 to the power minus 3 minus 0 over delta R, which is equal to 3 times 10 to the power 3 minus 0. Therefore, C is equal to 1 times 10 to the power minus 6 farads.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.